This is known as the Sinks or the Mini Grand Canyon. We're here in Orange County, California. This is a very special place because normally you can't hike here, but I'm gonna give you a sneak peek on what it's like to hike here, and I'll also show you how to see the Sinks for yourself. The hike starts in Southern California in the Limestone Canyon Nature Preserve, and it's right in the foothills of the Santa Ana Mountains, which you see back here. The hike is an out and back, about 9 miles, about 850 feet of climbing. We're going to go down Limestone Canyon, then go up Limestone Ridge to the Sinks viewing platform, and then go back from there. And just to note that there are plenty of other trails in the park. This is just the main route to the Sinks. You can choose your own adventure, and I'll tell you how you can plan that out for yourself at the end of the video. From the Augustine staging area, we're going to head down the Limestone Canyon Trail, and the trails are pretty well marked here. And when it is open, there will be docents here to help you go the right way. And if the trail looks like an old road, that's because it was. This was part of the Irvine Ranch, which is a cattle ranch dating back to the 1800s. And you can still see some of the vestiges of the old ranching life here. You can see some bones, you could see some old structures and everything. But basically the cattle grazed all of this land, grazed all of the native land, and now it's being restored. The land was given back to the county, Orange County, in 2010 by the Irvine Company. And now it's all part of the Irvine Ranch Natural Landmark System. Now, part of the restoration is removing invasive species. It's also reintroducing native species and helping native species thrive, whether it be plant or animal. Along the way here, you can see some of these butterfly habitat islands, which have native plants that butterflies like, and obviously the butterflies come and pollinates the other plants around this area. So a very, very cool part of this restoration effort. You might also see some of the trails closed if there's wildlife activity like this nesting raptor area. You might have to be routed around when you come visit, but it's all well marked. But keep your eyes open. Lots of raptors, lots of birds here. Now at around 2.2 miles, we're going to make the left onto a raptor. And this is only 0.3 miles, but it is uphill. We're going to go up to the ridge. And it's not too tough, it's pretty short, but the nice thing about this is if you're going up, just turn around or turn to your right, you're gonna get some great views down into Limestone Canyon, really beautiful. And if you turn around, you'll see a rock or a little hill that looks like an elephant's head. So take a look at that. You might need to use your imagination a little bit, but pretty cool. And then at the end of the raptor trail, we're gonna come up to Limestone Ridge. We're gonna be making the right-hand turn here for the last section, last 2 miles or so along Limestone Ridge. And you can see it's well signed. And Limestone Ridge was my favorite out of this hike. The views that you can get off to the east there, I guess, the Santa Ana Mountains are pretty spectacular. And just in general, the trail sort of winds up and down along the ridge and you get great views. It's just a really fun trail to do. You can see here, it's kind of narrow in spots, not narrow like you're going to fall off the edge, but narrow that you can get some incredible views. And there's some other trails here. We're just going to go straight on Limestone Ridge. There were a bunch of turkey buzzards the day I was here. Kind of cool. You see them all the time, but neat to see them up close. And we're just going to keep going straight. And when you get to this point here, if you look off to the right, you're going to get some great close-up views of the Sinks over here. These cliffs are sandstone, somewhere between 20 and 40 million years old, eroded over time, exposed, and this whole area actually used to be underwater, under the ocean, way back when. And just past that area, you're going to see a turnoff for the East Sinks viewing area, up to the right here. We're just going to climb up this towards the platform. And then when you get up to the platform, you're going to have these incredible panoramic views of the Sinks right here. Really neat, this little viewing platform they made. You can look down there, really soak it all in, and get all of the colors. Such a cool place. And again, you know, they call this the mini Grand Canyon of Orange County. I recommend just refueling at the viewing platform right here, and then you can come back the way you came, or you could take the Limestone Ridge Trail back all the way and enjoy the views up from the top of the ridge. Now, if you want to do this hike or any other of the hikes here in the park, you just go to the Irvine Ranch letsgooutside.org website, and here you can find the different things that are available, and we've got activities right here. You could see there's a list of all different hikes, and there's two different types of hikes. There are just the open park hikes where you can come in and hike on any of the trails and make up whatever you'd like to as long as it's open. Or there are guided hikes where you will go with a ranger or a docent who will show you around the park and point out things that you might not have otherwise seen. I really like this. I obviously hiked with some people who've been here for a while and really knew the park. They showed me different fossils. They took me into different parts of the park that were not normally open on general open days and showed me some very special things. So, you know, do what you want, whatever you have, whatever works into your schedule, come to this website, sign up for it, and experience this place. Best done in the winter or spring when it's nice and green. Really nice to check out. And obviously, bring the right equipment. This is a backcountry hike. You're going to want to have your hiking gear and plenty of water. Each one of these different hikes here will tell you a little bit about what you should bring with you and how to prepare for it and what your fitness level should be. If you have any questions, just leave me a comment under the video. I will do my best to answer or find an answer for you. And again, if you want to do this hike, I'll put the link to the website underneath this video as well so you can find out how to get here and do the hike yourself. And a big, big thank you to Annette, John, Steve, and Leandra who made this possible and did the hike with me. I couldn't have done it without you, so a big thank you. And yeah, folks, visit here if you can, and I'll see you out on the trails.